Hello friends, on request of many engineering students, I have come up with a topic that career options after BTech. I'm going to discuss today total 15 career options for BTech students, BTech or BE students. You know that most of the engineering students, they do not have much idea about the career options, what to choose. And in our Indian education system, the moment when student completes his 10th class, 80% will choose for MPC, Maths, Physics, Chemistry. And after that, 90% of MPC students will go to the BTech or BE, engineering only. Their option is engineering. And after engineering what? After BTech what? So here is it's a dilemma, and some students are going for campus placement, some students are blindly following their friends, and some students are outside of the home, outside of the university, don't know what to do, anything. So that is why it's very difficult. You know that in our India especially, every year lakhs of engineering students are coming out, and there's a lot of scarcity of jobs. And if you plan it properly, if you have a good understanding, you can just go ahead easily. So first of all, the moment when you are in second year of BTech or third year of BTech, please plan, have an understanding of career options. What are the career options? Where is my interest? What I am supposed to choose? Which field is suitable for me? Like, you ask yourself few questions, then you will have an understanding. Every year lakhs of people are coming out. So unless you have a proper planning, you won't be settling properly in your career. This is very important. The moment when you come out of the BTech, you will not find your friends, you will not find your professors also, no one, you will not find anyone. So that is why have a proper planning. Now in this video, I am going to give you the depth information about career options for the BTech students. First thing is that you must choose that after BTech, do you want to go for higher studies or job? Higher studies or job, this is very important. Most of the engineering students are feeling that want to go for job, no higher studies. Of course, there are many opportunities also there in MNC companies and the government jobs also there. So you can settle down easily in your career, but decide it whether you want to go for job or career. So this is very important dilemma question. So here, job or higher studies. Let me talk about job and higher studies clearly. Higher studies, when we talk about higher studies, it happens only once in lifetime. Having master's degree, definitely it will give you weightage for your career. Master's degree, either MTech, MS or MBA, whatever may be, but master's degree is a very good option, and only one time you can do it. Once if you enter into the job after BTech, you cannot go for this MTech degree or MS degree or MBA degree. It's not so easy because you have to do it regularly. No correspondence courses. Though MBA correspondence degrees are there, it's not much valid. So that is why it happens only one time in a year. So decide it, you want to go for higher studies. What are the advantages if you go for higher studies? The main thing is that you will get a master's degree. You will have profound knowledge in your technical field. And if you are interested in studies, please go. Not interested in studies, just for the sake of degree, if you go for higher studies, it is not much useful, not advisable also. So having interest and want to gain a profound knowledge, then go for higher studies. If you go for higher studies, you can get into the research and development, R&D. So get into the R&D field, or otherwise there are many options to become a lecturer, professor in universities. After BTech, MTech, after MTech, you can go for even PhD. You can easily settle down by the age of 30 years as a professor in any university. So this is possible. So that is why, see that higher studies happens only one time in a year. Interested, please go ahead. Now let me give you a detailed information about the higher studies. Now higher studies, first thing is, I would like to say MTech or ME. In some university we call it as a bachelor degree in engineering, BE, and some engineering colleges or some universities they call it as MTech, master's degree in technology. So whatever it may be, if you want to go for MTech or ME, please choose good universities, prestigious universities, prestigious institutions, like IIT, NIIT, BITS. this kind of universities you choose, this kind of courses you choose to become and to do your M.Tech. Doing M.Tech in local university, that doesn't give you much value. So for the sake of degree you'll be doing, but having a higher degree in any good universities, like as I told you, IIT, NIT, WITS, so in that case only it is much valid. Please focus, if you want to go for M.Tech or M.E., you have to do it from prestigious universities. For that, what you need to do, you have to write GATE exam. GATE exam, yearly once it will be conducted, probably in the month of February every year, February 1st week itself only, every year it will be conducted. GATE exam, if you write, you will have a lot of advantages. One thing is that you can take entry into IIT, NIT, or otherwise there are some PSUs, public sector undertakings. There also you can take job or good higher studies in a prestigious university, prestigious courses you can join. Anything is possible. So GATE is a good option. Start preparing right from the third year. You can take coaching from any good institution or otherwise get the material. Online coaching is also available. Whatever may be your choice, but if you wanted to go for M.Tech, please go for GATE. Have a thorough preparation and write the exam and get seat in IIT or NIT or bits of separate entrance test is there. So like you do it, even IIIT in Hyderabad also, we are having a very good option, IIIT Hyderabad. And IIIT is there in some other places also. So you can go for even IIIT, but do it. And if you do it from local universities, M.Tech, it is valid to become a lecturer, to become a professor. And after that you have to do PhD compulsory, otherwise no future at all. If you do it in local universities, if you do it from prestigious universities, you can start from there, or you can go for research and development, or you can go for a PhD, and that weightage is something different. So that is why this is M.Tech or M.E. This is first option. Then after that M.S. Want to do M.S. in other universities, other states, other countries. So please go ahead, but have a budget planning. How much will be the budget, and how much finance there you have to pay for them, and what is your standard of living and loan system, and all these things you have to be very careful about this. For MS, please find out GRE or TOEFL exams are required. You have to qualify, you have to get good score, high score, then only you will be eligible to take entry into the MS in other countries. So here you have to be very careful which country you are choosing and which university, what is the status of that university, what is the recognition is having to that university. So this is very important. Please have a good clarity, then only go for MS. And next option is MBA. Now when it comes to MBA course, BTech MBA, it's a good combination. Why it is a good combination, I'll explain you. Suppose you have done BTech degree in computer science or civil engineering or mechanical engineering, electronics or electricals, whatever may be your BTech degree, you will be joining as an engineer or assistant engineer in any organization as a software developer. After a certain period, you will be having good promotions and you will be entering into the managerial field. As a management, you will be entering three levels of management: lower level management, middle level management, and higher level management. Lower level management you can manage, but when it comes to middle level and higher level management, having MBA degree is always recommendable and always preferred. How? Let me give you an example. Suppose say A and B, both are the candidates who are competing for the higher level management. A is having only BTech degree and B is having BTech plus MBA from IMBA. So whom you are going to choose, definitely the weightage will be given to B. From IIM, a person who have done MBA and who is having just simple BTech degree, definitely there is a difference and preference will be given to the B only. So because of MBA degree, managerial skills are more for B. It's very clear. So that is why if you want to get into the managerial field, want to have a much growth are interested in managerial field and interested to do this MBA course, then only you please go for MBA. So MBA and BTEC, it's a good option. Please think about it. I'll give you much details about this MBA. So if you want to go for MBA, either middle management or higher level management, it is much useful. And options, you can choose options in MBA. So options are HR, marketing and operations management. These three options are good with BTEC. Never choose finance. Finance is not at all recommendable. Why BTEC students should not choose this finance? Because finance is such a subject, you need to have a depth knowledge. So only the commerce students who have done BCom or BBA, they'll be having much knowledge about finance, not others. Because 3 years they have studied debit, credit, this and that, depreciation account, branch account, this. Lot of topics they have studied 3 years, you can't compete with them. That's the reason I won't recommend a BTEC candidate to take MBA finance. Rather than that, you can take any HR, marketing or operations management. These are the options, you can choose it in MBA. And entrance, you are supposed to write CAT or MAT or local university tests also there. So I would prefer first CAT and MAT. Take always MBA seat in any prestigious universities like IIM and BITS is also good, and good universities like Delhi University and Bangalore University. There are many universities. In universities only try to take even IPE, Institute of Public Enterprises. This is also a good option. Like good institutions, you have to take entry as a MBA student. And there are local universities also. In local universities also, some universities are good. And recognized by the local universities, some colleges are there, private colleges. So if you choose in private colleges, it's not much valid, you will not have much weightage. So that is a please be careful which university you are choosing. I would prefer you to go for IIM or otherwise any good university. BITS is also good, and like Delhi University and whatever universities I said, you can just go ahead. This is a good option. Please write this test, prepare for CAT, MAT. And local universities are conducting their test in only for that area. So like in Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, we have ISET. ISET exam for the MBA entrance in local universities and local colleges also for this ISET exam. Like in your state, you'll be finding some local tests also just like ISET. So this is there. And what are the qualities are required? What are the skills are required to become a proper MBA? Having good command over MBA subjects and complete MBA candidate. How you can become? These are the skills required. The main skills are communication skills. Good communication skills, having good command and speaking continuously, flawless. And body language is important. Along with that, creative skills and teamwork, leadership skills, problem solving skills, decision making. These are the managerial skills we expect from any MBA candidate. So if you take entry into MBA, so these are the skills required. And as a technical student, you might be having just technical knowledge. I'll do my duty, I'll get out from the organization, I'll complete my job is finished. This wouldn't be the attitude of MBA students. So that is why. So these are the skills required. Want to get into MBA? Please think about all these things. Interested? Want to be MBA? And having a passion of speaking and having a passion of leadership skills and team building skills, and as I told you, creative thinking, problem solving skills, anything such kind of skills, if you are interested, please go ahead, do MBA. So these are the higher studies, MTech, MS and MBA. Any of these three options you can go ahead. Now I'll give you the information about job opportunities. Learning or earning. If you want to learn, higher studies. Want to earn, job. So what are the job opportunities? BTEC is a good degree, solid degree, and 4 years, many semesters, many subjects you have done, and you have a very good knowledge, you can just go ahead for the job also. What are the job opportunities? The first one is that campus placements. If you are studying in a good organization, good university, definitely there will be a lot of campus placements. Good companies will be coming for the campus placements. By seeing each other, you will be preparing, you will be going to get a job. It's a very good option. Getting job in campus placements. Once if you leave your campus, once if you leave the university, once if you leave your college, it's very difficult. You have to compete with everyone. So there is a cutthroat competition as an open candidate. That's the reason campus placements are a good option. If you get a job in campus placements, it's a very good one. You need to prepare a lot. Regarding this campus placements, I have already prepared a video. I'll give you the link in the description box, or you can just type it in YouTube, Devika Bhatnagar campus placements. You'll get that video. So campus placements are very important. Get a job, but see the company, which company is coming for the campus recruitments, and what is the package and security of job. All these things find out and then go for campus placement. It is one of the options. And second one is that PSUs, public sector undertakings. Public sector undertakings are also giving a very good option for the BTech students. By writing GATE exam, GATE score is must to take entry to public sector undertakings. By writing GATE exam, by clearing it with that score, you can apply for any kind of public sector undertakings like DRDO, BHEL and ISRO, BARC, etc. etc. There are a lot of public sector undertakings. So you can get job into those organizations with the score of GATE. GATE cleared, score is there, and they'll conduct a written test, and after that interview, a small interview, then after that you can take a government, central government job. It's the safest and always good option. So please focus on this public sector undertakings. And third one is that ESI. ESI means Engineering Services Exam. UPSC is conducting yearly once this ESI exam. So this is for all engineering candidates. By writing this ESI exam, most of the time you will be getting your subject knowledge only. You have to write the subject only, all the questions from the subject related to your field. And if you can clear this, you can get job into the railways or defense, and some other companies also, some other organizations also giving you good government job. So because of this ESI exam, please focus on this, see the notification of ESI, and don't ignore it. Though you have done 2 years, 5 years back BTech, it doesn't matter, but you are eligible to write this ESI exam. So focus on this, it's a good option. And next one is that some candidates with a strong determination want to be in high position, and they'll try for the civil services. Civil services is also a good option. But for this, what is needed is having a depth knowledge of your subject, and having a passion, and having a determination to concentrate and prepare it. So these are the main things which are required to get into the civil services. And most of the engineering students will be going for the options like anthropology or history, civics or something else. I don't recommend you to go for such kind of options. Please opt your engineering subject. If you have done mechanical engineering, so please opt mechanical only. If you have done civil, go for civil. Electronics, yes, you can go. Computer science, whatever maybe you are choose that option. And what is the use of 4 years BTech degree when you go for history or some other subjects as an option? No. So that is why please choose your options only. So civil services is also a very good option. But if you want to go for civil services, take coaching. Proper institute is needed, and proper material is needed, and thorough preparation, and referring the old question papers, attending mock interviews, lot of preparation is required. So I'll talk about the civil services in depth in some other video. Now right now, job opportunities, if you want to go, these are the government jobs you are having. Through the campus placements you can get private job, but it's a good job you can get. And PSUs, public sector undertakings, are there. By writing GATE exam, you can apply for any kind of PSUs. And ESI, so that's Engineering Services Exam, yearly once UPSC is conducting, and civil services. These are the good options. Suppose say you are not interested in your engineering by mistake, fate is not good, you have entered somehow in engineering, you have finished with backlogs or whatever, maybe not interested in engineering, then I'm giving you other options also. Don't get disappointed. Engineering backlogs are there, I could not complete it, or somehow with difficulty I have completed but not interested in engineering field, ignore it. Forget about the past, change your field. Just like in 3 Idiots movie, Madhavan has changed engineering to wildlife photographer. Yes, you can. But passion, where is your passion? Where it is taking you, where it is guiding you, that is much important. Other options, simple options I'm telling you. Apart from this also you can choose. One is lecturer or professor. Engineering is completed. If you are interested in your field, you can take, go for M.Tech, simple M.Tech. You can do it in local university or any university and you can become a lecturer or professor. So this is a good option. If you are interested in teaching, otherwise no. Next, entrepreneur. You can become an entrepreneur. You can start your own business like solo entrepreneur. You can start by yourself by taking the help of someone. Or otherwise, you can be collaborated with already existing entrepreneur or otherwise 2-3 of your classmates or colleagues can become entrepreneurs. You can start up your business, so that you can do. Or you can enter into the multimedia. This is also evergreen course. Learn some diploma or some other course in multimedia and you can become a very good job holder in multimedia. There are many opportunities in the present scenario. And event manager, this is also a very good option. You can just go ahead. And travel agent and manager, evergreen course this is, evergreen option this is. Anyone can do. Hotel management is also welcome. Anyone can enter into this field, but if you have a passion of cooking, passion of hotel management, then you can just go ahead. It doesn't matter, your basic degree was B.Tech, it doesn't matter. In the same way, fashion designing also you can go, and also photography. Any course you can do. Any course. So, but choice is yours. Please have a clear understanding about this and have an understanding. Want to go for higher studies or job? Higher studies means learning. Job means earning. What do you want? If you want to go for higher studies, what do you want to do? If you want to go for a job, what is a good option? Please choose the best choice. Whatever you choose, your choice will give you 40 years of life. 40 years you will be happy with your choice. If you struggle now, if you take a right choice. So please think about it. What do you want to become in future? Decide it, plan it, struggle for that and just go ahead. So everything is in your hands. Enjoy your field, enjoy your life. And you won't be knowing that you are working or you are doing something. If you like your field, it will be just like playing in that passion. What do you say? Please think it and take a wise decision, my dear B.Tech students. And have a bright future. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe to this channel. And share this video with all the B.Tech students. And juniors also. So that they can have an understanding about career options after B.Tech. So till then, please take care. So wish you good luck, keep smiling, keep shining, take care.